Hello and welcome. I have Ravi Teja with me. Congratulations, you have qualified your UGC NET exam in June 2019 in the subject of commerce. How are you feeling about qualifying this exam?
I'm feeling very happily. It is almost a person of 1.5 years, right? At that time, I feel so much happily. It is now, I also qualified AP set, and recently I have written CU set for also for PhD. So I'm feeling so excited for the result.
So you decided to give NET because you were interested in teaching. What was the motivation?
So actually, teaching is my passion. From childhood also, I have interested to in the field of teaching, to come into the teaching field. And actually, I'm a CA student. I'm pursuing CA Inter. So, with the commerce subjects, I have a good subject knowledge and grip on the subjects. Yeah, that's the reason I come to the teaching field. And I also have some good communication skills also there.
Yes. Amazing. So, now you've qualified the state eligibility test also, and you're now planning to pursue PhD.
Yes.
Great. So tell us more about yourself. Which city are you from? Where were you born? And about your education?
Okay. I am from Kadapa, from Andhra Pradesh. I born and grown up in Kadapa itself. I studied up to my degree also in Kadapa. For PG, I came to the Tirupati, SV University. Then I prepared for the NET and AP set on my own with the human test material only for paper one, and for the commerce also I prepared, I studied so many books, others books, and with the human test material also I prepared my own.
So going directly into your preparation strategy, what you had in mind and how much time did you dedicate between paper 1, paper 2, how did you divide your time?
I can't say it is easily because I didn't plan it. I just prepared what the I studied in a well planned manner. I taken 1 to 2 months for paper 1 and other times I spent for paper 2. When I'm studying MCOM, from this final year, I planned how to prepare for NET and AP set. Okay, so I taken all the previous material, previous question papers, and just checked how the questions are asking in the upcoming examinations. What is the logic is there in the paper one, mostly with the reasoning topic and communication topic. So I just recap the earlier question papers and planned in that manner how the examiner asking these questions, and going through the and went through the all these topics.
So commerce is a big subject. There are so many sub parts in the syllabus. So was there any particular thing that challenged you the most, or can we call it difficult for you?
Actually, commerce is my interest subject, so much interest I have in that. I feel I didn't feel anything bored with that, anything difficult in commerce. Somewhere when come to the corporate accounting, I feel some difficulty, and others are where it comes to taxation and business laws, I can take it easily. I scored 20 to 20 out of both units on the business law and the taxation paper. Both units I got out of.
And you gave the exam immediately after you completed your master's. So do you think that gave you some advantage because you were in touch with the subjects?
Yeah, of course, ma'am. And also I am from CA background, right? So I have that knowledge in the paper 2 when it comes to paper 2 mostly. For paper 1, I did the hard work to get the score.
So, if you had to give advice to someone who is going to sit for this exam and has never faced the exam before, what advice will you give?
I advise all the students going through the self-preparation and with the human test materials or any other institutes who support the students, for their own, depending on their own thought, own thoughts or own planning to prepare. So I gone with the, my self preparation only. I didn't went for any institute. So I didn't spend so much of money. I didn't waste. So many institutes are there for the NET exams. So they took so many admissions, right? Okay. There was all the people, only few people are get passed, right? But when we go with the self preparation, we know how the questions are asking. Then we check up the earlier question papers. All we came to know with my with our own analysis, right? That only I will suggest.
So going through the previous year papers and doing your own analysis as to what is asked by the examiner is your advice. And if you could point out something that you realized after giving the exam, like something that you could have avoided, some mistake or something that wasted your time, would there be anything that you can point out?
I actually passed the NET exam in the third attempt, ma'am. I given my first attempt in June 2018. In June 2019, I get passed UGC NET. When I came to this paper one, I lost score in paper one only. For earlier two attempts, first two attempts, I lost marks in paper one only. Then I got a human patents medal for second attempt. I attempted first attempt blindly. I didn't prepare well. But from second attempt, I studied well and planned well how to prepare the, how to complete the syllabus within time and attempt more questions in a restricted time period. So I get completed finally in the third attempt. So paper one is very difficult to me. Then come to the mathematics topics are there, some arithmetic reasonings are there, aptitude. So that is somewhere difficult to me in compared to others.
So advice is to focus on paper one as much as paper two, because that can be the deal breaker when it comes to scoring the cutoff.
Because paper one, paper two is already will cover in PG subjects are there. When come to the, but paper one is not like that, na. So we have to prepare them.
Totally makes sense, and those are very, very valuable inputs for somebody who's planning to give the exam. And thank you so much for taking out time and sharing your experience with other students. And from our side, we wish you all the best for your future endeavors in teaching and research. And we wish you all the best. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Thank you.